Fair & Lovely has decided to drop Fair from its brand name. For decades, a cream which has been sold as a fairness cream is now being targeted as a skin lightening cream. Well, this is the brand's response to the global increasing unrest towards racial slurs and racial injustice. So guys, here I am, Avi, and you guys are watching Minding My Business. And we have a very special guest with us, the very lovely Tripti Sagar, who's an Instagram blogger, social blogger, model, and an actress. So Tripti, welcome to our show Minding My Business. And getting straight to the point, Hindustan Lever has decided to drop the name Fair from the brand Fair & Lovely. And there is a company called RHS Global, and whose chairman, Mr. Sunil, has apparently commented that dropping the name Fair is not actually helping, because at the end of the day, even if it is called Lovely, it's going to be still sold as a fairness cream. So what he wants to say is, if the whole thing can be, you know, the whole idea of selling this cream itself can be stopped. I mean, the whole product to be taken out of the market. I mean, do you have any thoughts about this?
I think there should not be any kind of a product like which lightens your skin. You cannot really lighten your skin by any kind of product. It's just not there. And somehow building up this insecurity into people, like, okay, I need to get a bit fair or something, so they will go and buy it and everything. No, it will actually keep this kind of an insecurity in people's mind about the fairness claim and everything. So why should you even have this kind of product on the first place? You should definitely stop this thing. The moment there is so much out there in what we know and what's happening in the USA, and then the moment came like the Black Lives Matter. Well, somehow that's really true. Because personally also you feel like, okay, but the whole marketing strategy of the whole fairness cream came up like, okay, if you are dark, you cannot get married, you cannot get a job or something. To be honest, those things are still there. People who are from a different nationality or they have a lighter skin color, they are preferred to be in an office just because it just gives them an international feel. The office and the whole brand and everything. So for me, and for everybody out there, it's just like not gonna work. Like, you cannot just put a cream on your face and say, okay, I'm going to get Gora or something. No, you don't get Gora like this. The thing should be dropped out anyway. People should actually protest about this thing that can be cream the better.
So Tripti, amidst all this backlash, I mean, when a cream company, when they do something like this, is it a good example? Like, now, because it's not just Fair & Lovely, like, you have a Fair & Handsome for men. And you have like so many creams worldwide, in every country, I believe there is something. So when a brand does something like this, is it going to be a trend? Do you see this becoming a trend now? Or like this is just a one-off, you think? I mean, it happened now because of the backlash?
See, backlash is there, theek hai. But the thing is, like, it has given people of a mind change thing. Like, okay, so I don't know what future hold. It depends on our future generation, like how we actually make them believe that every color should be treated equal, every color is beautiful. Okay, but over here, like building this kind of brand now, there are so many example Fenty Beauty, which is actually Rihanna's beauty line, and I really love that line because that beauty line first came up with 40 shades of skin color. It has every shade for black, brown, and everybody. And people, they started using this kind of, like, okay, body positive. Why do you think Victoria's Secret got banned? Because they actually started selling this kind of, no, women should be something like this. No, every woman is different. Every woman body part is different. So start accepting it. That's the reason why right now the share market for all the Victoria's Secret brand has been completely dropped.
I think
out.
They even closed out in UK, but I don't know if this is for this reason or something, but I think Victoria's
Secret. Even the show, what, the fashion show happens.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
also not airing. Yeah. Why? Because it kind of a complex. I don't want to watch that show. Why? Because when I see myself, I'm sorry, I don't have that time for me. I'm trying my best to do all those things, but I cannot.
True.
And building this kind of a fairness thing, like, you are putting thing in the Indian people's mind. If you, just one thing, if you go around Taj Mahal, if there's any kind of a local, like locals, and plus there's any international foreigners who come, people will take more selfies with that foreigners.
True.
Acha Gora and everything, then Taj Mahal.
Yeah.
So, white skin matters that much in our country. this is really hurtful. When I see this kind of thing, this is really hurtful. This kind of sets the mindset of our like, it's just like, what, are we racist? Are we really racist where we actually come up with a country like a socialism and everything, and no country like in our anthem we speak so much, but are we seriously that racist that just because someone is brown you don't consider them that pretty? Just Google it, five most paid models. You will see five of them are fair, like
all
white.
All whites, yeah.
You will see very less brown or black, only for the sake of a brand that they do get labeled. You know, this thing, they will take one or two brown, which is like Neelam from Canada. Neelam, okay. I follow her on Facebook, on Instagram. So she's the only one. I don't remember if there's any other brown model or any other black model. I don't know like if there are any. So this thing is there, and if you see on the voting booth around the world, you will see white people, that's it. Like even over here, you will only see white people, black people, or either they are just characterized. Okay, like if they are from South Africa, they would be looking like this. No, it's everywhere.
So Tripti, I mean, one more thing which I have noticed is, I mean, as consumers, even they have evolved, but the problem is from decades. I mean, I'm not talking about 2000s, maybe from the 90s. When an advertisement is shown where a dark female comes and she's given a cream and then suddenly she becomes as white as milk, as white as teeth. I mean, this is something, this is the way when you market it to someone, obviously a consumer is going to come and say, oh, I want to become like her. I mean, when you feed this to the customer, they're going to take it. So do you think it's the advertisement itself first? I mean, product is fine, somebody made it, you know. We are pitching it very wrong. I mean, the pitching was itself the biggest problem where it all started.
Yes, definitely. Like the marketing thing, like as I mentioned at the very start of this thing, like, okay, people are saying that, like, no, the brown skin girl or something, you won't get the job or this thing and all those things. So people have this kind of a mindset now built that can make. A gora rang hi sab kuch best hai. And somehow deep inside, I fetish that. Why? Because somehow I've been also a target with the brown kind of skin issues. Why? Because when I want to pursue my, I'm into the modeling of course, fairly I got some chances where they need an Indian, Pakistani, Asian woman. So I get those chances. But when I want to perform into a magazine or any international brand, they just don't want me. Okay, over here or anywhere, there was
it's
a magazine.
A problem.
Yeah, there was a magazine that I really wanted to work with them, and I was it was like a front cover thing. Okay, I wanted to work with my agent, even really try to put me there, but at the end they took a white figure. And the photos came, and I was literally saying like, dude, I am an influencer. I have my degree of MBA.
That didn't matter.
I would have given them much more answers, like much more content. To build this whole thing, but no, that just didn't happen. They wanted to have a fairer people, and somehow this thing has been there for ages. My mom has suffered this thing by herself because she's a brown woman. Sasuma, even my father, and everybody in her family, they used to call her Kali Kali and everything. My buas used to like push her hand away, like, "Nahi, yaar, mere baby ke samne tum kaam wali lagti ho." Literally, this kind of a thing was being spoken, okay? And like till now, it's there. She always feel like, "Nahi, yaar, kaash rang thoda gora hota to izzat badhti." But rang gora se you don't gain respect. You gain respect by how you present yourself, how you present your mind, how you actually work with people, how you talk with people. Your color has no pride. Color has no pride. I experienced this thing. I was in a restaurant with my friend. Okay, now she is a fair person. Contact lenses laga diya tha, okay, so bure lagte ho. And there comes, I was just, we were just having shisha and I was in my pajamas. I didn't put any effort on myself. So person comes from an Asian guy, a Filipino guy. She kind of gets attracted to that lady and like, "Oh, where are you from?" And she's like, "Please, yes." And he's like, "Okay, you don't look Indian."
No.
And she said like, "Oh, you don't look Indian." So, because Indians look like her, she's brown.
That is how they're perceived.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They look like brown. You know, people, and then she actually kind of had that pride moment, "Okay, I look fairer and everything." And many times I've been taunted by my friend that, okay, I'm bold, my skin is like this, my skin is this, I don't get tan, I get work because of my skin. You know, and this is true, people do get work. Makeup artists just don't want to paint brown skin like me, but they want to paint people like who are fair because their foundations are very easy. Now they don't have a foundation of my shade, so what they do, they make me fair or either they make me dark. So they don't want to, like, they are like, okay, clear skin. I have a clear skin. I take really good care of my skin. Okay, but why cannot I be on such platforms? Like, this is one of my dreams, to be on a platform, on a magazine or on a holding board. Like, I can say that yes, I made it, but because of these circumstances, I cannot.
True. I mean, it's sad that it turns out that way. But
this thing has been there forever. I think since the British has invaded India and we have been their slaves, so we have things that have certain kind of thing in our mind. जो गोरे होते हैं दे आर द डॉक्टर्स, जो राजा होते हैं वो गोरे होते हैं, तो वो लोग शहद से नहाते हैं, ये नहाते हैं. And the labor caste has always been considered as a brown or black.
As a brown or black.
Black men or women, they have considered themselves slaves. And people who have slaughtered them, they have their statues somewhere in America. They have been broken by them, right?
Tripti, so I've been reading blogs and recently the West Indies, ex-West Indies cricket captain Darren Sammy.
Yeah.
So even he complained that he has faced racial slurs in India, and he was surprised to hear that there is a brand which actually makes fairness creams in India, obviously talking about Fair and Lovely. And I mean, to again stress that India as a nation, we are not naturally white people.
Yeah.
Like UK, US or anywhere like Australia. So when you sell a cream like this in India, and when you advertise it in a way where you are showing a lady, obviously what I talked in the previous question. So I mean, the problem is then people are actually longing to become white. I mean, when you show that you are becoming white, you are actually saying that this is a better color. So this is a problem where, you know, the thoughts of the people itself are like this. And there are celebrities obviously who have not helped at all by actually, you know, promoting all these kinds of creams. So I mean, I wanted to know what do you think about it?
See, India promotes colorism, which actually shows that yes, India is a racist country, and we move in somewhere with the whole the rate kind of a thing. It shows that India is racist, because North Indian ki South Indian ke saath hai, why they still call them Madrasi? It's just because they don't want to say, because their color is way darker than even brown.
Sadly.
And and when you sell the fairness cream to them, it hurts their sentiments. Like, we can't do anything. Are you just saying us on our face that we are ugly and we cannot have any opportunity, we cannot get married just because we are dark? No, it should not happen like that. So for me, I personally say ban this whole thing. And somehow I feel very sad, like our the celebrities. Now celebrities nowadays are, they are influencers itself.
Yeah.
They say anything people want, they wear anything people want them. Some of like Shah Rukh Khan, these are people, pick any big names, they have promoted fairness scheme, Yami Gautam. They promoted themselves of fairness scheme just to, in future interviews, they just change their whole just to get safer. They change their whole narrative.
Yeah.
No. After doing this, I felt really regret. And I think, no, you should have such kind of dreams not to sign
not
up
to
for
sign
this
up
thing.
For that, yeah.
You should not sign up on the very first time itself. So, is tarike se ye sari cheeze hoti, it's just wrong. You are promoting it, and people from outside West Indies or anybody who are black, they will come over here. They have faced racism. Okay, not every black person is a criminal, not every black person is a drug dealer. People have made this kind of a dilemma, like, okay, either they are slaves or either they are criminals. If a Gora, a foreigner, a white skinned guy, justice has not been served, like if they do anything wrong, justice does not serve that quickly. But when it's happened to a black guy, they just get into jail really quick.
Yeah, yeah.
Why? Because people say, like, white skin, skin is fairer. People who do who are white skin, they don't do anything wrong.
So Tripti, strictly from a different point of view, I mean, obviously there are people who want to be fairer. There are such people, are there, and they still probably are waiting for the creams to come out. And with all this happening throughout the world, and this is a very welcome change, of course. But then, do you think because of this now, say, Fair & Lovely 2, say there will be another company who will, say, make another cream like this? Of course, we don't want such creams to exist, but do you think now marketing a cream like this is much difficult than before, like with the way they were going on?
I think the mindset, it's really hard for people to change that thing. It will only happen if we teach our future generation. Like example, if you want to teach your future generation that do not discriminate within colors, you have to let them play with the black doll itself.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a YouTube video of black doll and white doll. You have to, and honestly, there's no fairness cream, but there is a thing called whitening your skin with injections or something. People have become whiter. If you see any Bollywood actresses before and now, when they
drastic.
Are drastic change in their skin color. If you see Deepika Padukone, you will see like her skin has been somewhere
played with.
Because obviously now they have money, they can do skin bleaching, exfoliating, just to take off the first layer of their skin. So this thing is there. People, I think personally, I feel it will take a big, big amount of mental. A mental thing or a kind of a big learning, honestly, a big learning to change this kind of a dilemma of making the brown or black skin as equal to any other skin. So it just takes a huge responsibility for people who are making skincare products or any entrepreneurs. Example, I want to be an entrepreneur by myself. I want to make makeup and everything. So my first thing is like, the makeup company should be for every woman.
Yeah.
The shade should be for every woman, from either like they are white, black, brown, hijabi, non-hijabi, anybody out there. It should be equal to every woman.
Yep.
It should be equal to every man. So we are making a fair and handsome thing. You cannot just say, okay, a fair guy can only be handsome. No, there's a thing we say for a really long time, dark, tall, dark and handsome. There's a thing why we say tall, dark and handsome. Achanak, say you just came up with the fair and handsome. So first you targeted the women, and now you're targeting the men. So dheere dheere karke you're building the poison. So you should not do that. So you should stop this thing. So on my opinion, these kind of marketing strategy, people will come up to sell their things because they know our emotions, they know our insecurity. So they will play with them. So that's my whole thing.
I mean, so many things to talk about, Yukti, and I mean, we are actually coming to an end to our podcast, and I think we could do a whole new episode again. And guys, please tell us what you think about our podcast. And there are a lot of things which we have not discussed, me and Tripti here, which we could actually do it some other day again. Tripti, thank you very much for coming to this show. And guys, please like, comment and subscribe. Tripti, you want to say, please?
Please stop buying fairness creams. Love yourself, love the color you are in, and just love yourself. Let the world change you, you change the world. So that's it.
Cheers.